Welcome to the Django project, DJ Blogger. This tutorial is part of a YouTube Django project playlist, which you can access in the video description. You can watch the whole course from the very beginning. If you enjoy this course and would like all the updated tutorials and associated code samples and more, you can check out this course and other courses this project features at Udemy. The link to the course is in the video description. So that we can better style our post content and to allow the author to add additional features such as headings and other elements, we're going to incorporate a markdown tool to allow users to utilize markdown within the post and then for us to then be able to utilize that metadata that's generated to then style our post. So let's find a markdown editor. Right, so let's go markdown PyPy. So I think we're going to be utilizing Python markdown PyPy, Python markdown. So let's go ahead and just copy that. Let's go back into our project. Make sure that you're in your virtual environment. Let's go ahead and pip install markdown. Cool. So that's a markdown installed. So that we can utilize this, let's go ahead and just make sure that we have an admin user. So I'm going to type in Python 3, manage.py, and then create a super user if you don't already have one. So let me call this admin. So the admin is already taken. Now I don't know the password for this. Now the reason why admin is taken, because when we set up our data, if you remember, we created a new user. So inside of our blog, our factory here, we created a new user automatically. Now we didn't specify a password, so that didn't really help us there. So we should probably do that. So let's call this admin. Let's just call this root. There we go. No password. I type in root here. You can't see it, of course. Didn't match. Oh. Okay. So root and root. So let's get back into our server. Cool. So let's go back into our application here. Let's go into our admin. Let's type in admin, admin, oh, no, it's root, apologies, root and root. There we go. So let's go to our post and let's just open up our top post here. So what we're trying to do here, you can see that Django provides these tools here and there's not too many things that we can do with this other than to type some text and then to add some line breaks, if you like. So what we might want to do is add a title, so something like this. Now, the problem is that there's no way of styling that. So we add in some meta tags, if you like. We're adding some markdown here. So then we can then format that within our template and then use CSS to then format that. So if you're new to markdown, let's have a look at markdown and take a look at some of the different options. So the basic syntax of markdown. So you can see here that this is a heading. So what's going to happen here is that we're going to write this. So we're going to type this in right here. And then when we then output that to our template, you see that it's going to be outputted with the H1 tags. Now, because it has tags, we can then set up CSS to style it. So the idea is that we're using this markdown to style our page so that we can then take the tags when it's been added to our HTML page to style it. Okay, you can see here that in Markdown, there's lots of different settings and options. If you want different headings and so on, line breaks, we can make things bold and so on. So there's a whole heap of stuff there that you might want to include. And this is going to be a basic feature. If you're going to create posts, you'll want to add that type of those type of elements or features into your post. So let me just show you an example then of just the header, and then you can go ahead and have a look at the basic syntax, see what type of tags it's going to produce, p tags or whatever, and then you can go ahead and style that appropriate to your requirements. So let's keep that there. So I'm just going to publish this. I press save. So that's someone's stage. Okay, so let's go back to the site. So that was this here. And you can see at the moment we've got this here. It just says heading. So what we want to do now is to convert that into our H1 tags and then style it through what we've just installed here, the package that we've just installed. So we're going to make a new in our Django blog here, we're going to make a new template tag. So let's create a new template tag, and we're going to utilize that tag to actually apply or to connect, if you like, our package, our Markdown package, to our content. So it then formats it and then puts it into code, which we can then style. So let's create a new file. I'm going to call this Markdown Processing, maybe. Let's call it Markdown Processing.py. Okay, so inside of here, then we just need to create our new tag. So let's import Markdown as MD. Let's go ahead and from Django, let's import, what do we need? We need template, and then from Django.template default filters. Let's go ahead and import the string filter. Go straight to the Django documentation. You can see here that what we're doing here, this will convert an object into a string value before it's being passed to your function. Right, so let's go ahead and register. So register equals template library. And then let's go ahead and now at register.filter. And then let's make sure that we use the string filter. And then let's now create a new function called Markdown. It's going to take in the value, our text, and then it's going to perform the function. So what we want to return is the text that's then formatted. So the Markdown is then processed. So return MD Markdown, and then pass in our code, and then extensions equals, and this is going to be markdown.extensions fenced code. So if you want to learn a little bit more about fence codes blocks, then just head over to the Markdown documentation, give you a brief overview of what it means by fence code blocks and the different options that are available. Okay, so that's going to then be applied. Now, typically, we probably want to utilize this maybe on multiple pages or not. So we can go ahead and, like we did previously, if we go into our DJ Blogger and then our settings and then go into the base here, remember we utilized this built in here. We added it so it's site wide. So we could also make this site-wide. So let's do that. So we're just going to register the tag site-wise so we can utilize it on any page. So let's use a comma here, and then let's go for the same again, but this time it's called something slightly different. So templates tag dot, we called it Markdown Processing, I think. So inside of our blog, template tags, Markdown Processing. There we go. Okay, so we just register that globally. And let's close that. So that's in our base settings. Right, so now we just go back to our single page. Now this is where the actual post content is going to be displayed. So now we need to just add our new Markdown tag, and then we can also use safe here. Using safe here, you can read through this if you like, but essentially we are indicating to Django that the value that we're passing here is known to be safe, and therefore doesn't need to be escaped. So hopefully everything is now nicely connected. So let's start up our server again. Looks like it's starting okay. So whereas we had this before, remember, just had the hashtag heading. Hopefully now that's been formatted and now we have a heading. And of course, Bootstrap behind the scenes has seen that tag and now it just styles it for us. Now, of course, we want to style that individually. So let's go back to our heading here. Now, this is the styling for our H1 at the moment. So let's go ahead and change this. So what we might want to do here then is wrap our post content up in a new div. And then we can then apply a class to that and then utilize that class like this. So let's call this a post, class post. And let's go ahead now and add dot post H1. So any H1s inside of here are going to be styled in this manner. So let's go ahead and add a font size of, say, 18 pixels. So that should be applied to any of the H1s inside of here. Now, obviously, that's been generated by our Markdown tool. So let's refresh. You can now see we've changed that. So hopefully you can start to see now that we will add Markdown when we write this out. Markdown will then be converted into tags. Some of them will be converted into tags. And then we can go along and within our CSS, we can then add some styling. So let's just add this to 24 for now. There we go. Let's just finish up by changing the font weight to bold or 700. There we go. And then in addition to that, what we now need to do is set the text to a different font. Now remember, we have already included, if we go back to our blog and in our static file, sorry. So in our static here, in our main, we did import this last text font here that we're going to be utilizing for our text. So let's just add this in to here. So font family, that's going to be Merriweather. So let's set that up. There we go. So now we have our font. Now you can see that we've added some different styling here. So let's apply that. So what we're going to need to do is add some, let's change the font size. Let's go for 1.0625 rem, which I think is around about 17 pixels. Line height, let's go for 32 pixels. And then letter spacing, let's make it a little bit wider. Give us a go. And there we have it. So that's pretty much everything up until this point. You might want to play around with the different heading, padding, and so on. I'm not going to do that in this case. But hopefully you can start to see now how that's been formatted. So let's just see how that scales. You can see that it's probably a little bit wider, the line height, but I'm not picky at this point. So what we probably also want to do here is we want to probably scale down. We probably want to scale down this text maybe at a smaller screen or not, completely up to you. So to do that, of course, we would need to add maybe an at media here, like we've done previously. So at media, set the width. You want to change the font size and have a smaller font size maybe at a mobile view. That's maybe something you can add there, but hopefully you can start to see now how Markdown is utilized. You'll need to obviously go through the Markdown. If you're not familiar to Markdown, have a look at some Markdown content, give you an idea of what you can include in your post, and then you can start to utilize that and utilize your style to start styling it. And of course here, because we're styling here in the template, that can be applied to all of our posts. So before we finish this, let's just add a little bit more padding here, because you can see that this is slightly different. Yeah, just slightly different. So let's go ahead and just add some padding at the top here and spread this out a little bit more. So for that, let's go into our templates and our base. So here we're going to apply it within our div right here. So this is the middle section. So let's add some padding at the top, 5. Let's add some padding left and right, 4. And then let's change that at a wider view. So that's going to be MD, that's going to be maybe 5 at MD and bigger. And then let's change, let's change it to maybe 8. No, let's change it to 5. 5 is good. 5, 8 doesn't exist. What I'm talking about. Okay, let's try that. Okay, so we've now got some space at the top here. Maybe a little bit more space at the sides. You can see now, I think the spacing has changed to the left and right now at the smaller view. Make a little bit more sense there. Okay, so that's looking all right. Right, so let's add some padding right here below, I think, the date. Yes. So below the date, let's grab the date. That's going to be here. And let's add some padding at the bottom. Let's go for 5 to begin with. Okay.